after eating lots, so you'll not have food.
Yes.
So Aiden Me is a small skit trying to represent the lives and the dichotomies that aid volunteers generally find themselves caught up in. And what's significant this year is this is the 10th year of that script, of the skit that, you know, started on just through a discussion of a few volunteers way back in Columbus. On the steps of the University of Ohio in Columbus, this group came together. And every year, these eight volunteers, you know, explore the dichotomies, the dilemmas that eight volunteers find themselves in. Much like what Arvinda just said, right? We might be fighting, you know, for the landless, talking about that, but we might have absentee landlords so close to us that, you know, it takes us a while to, you know, understand what to do, what is the right way to go, and such. So these are very real life situations. And also another thing I think with Aid and Me, we try to bring in is not to take ourselves too seriously, you know, being able to maintain that space to be able to laugh at our own selves and laugh at each other, make fun at each other without offending people. And so in that spirit, this year, the sort of the title is Volunteer Cycles in Aid. And for those who are not familiar, the Aid and Me started with two characters, Ever Ready and Never Ready. And then 2 years ago, there was a new addition to the character set who was called Newer Reddy. So we'll just play it out and let us see how best we can do it with the mic.
Screen.
Is it okay to?
The screen.
Okay. And many volunteers contribute to this. Hey man, Neva, seems like I haven't seen you in ages.
Hey, can you all use the mic?
There's only one.
That's what we talked about.
There's only one, so come forward, no? If there are three seats.
Yeah, there's a lot of seats here.
Video just... pick up better.
Yeah, but there's only one mic. Oh,
okay. You want to try? We can try.
Chairs, pass it around.
Yeah, can everybody come forward?
It's easy to move. No excuse to
move. Let people come.
So let's hold it at distance, whatever it catches.
Yeah. You can put it in part of it.
No, we'll talk like this. So. Hey man, Never. Seems like I haven't seen you for ages.
Yeah man, it's been a while.
Yeah, it almost feels like the last time you were at a regular CSH was way back and when I had pitch black hair. And Mona and Somnath were cool and happening couple in eight.
No, not that long ago, man. I mean the black hair part of it. Mona and Somnath are still very cool.
When were you last regular and energized as an aid volunteer? Before the last stock market crash?
Something like that. I hate to say this, but off late, aid has been a serious drag on me, and I've been having trouble getting motivated and showing up.
Dude, if you started doing one of those weekend executive MBAs, just say so. You don't need to trash aid to justify your tardiness.
Okay, but you know, getting a quorum has become so difficult that when we do it, it almost feels like we averted a no-confidence motion. And thus, in our relief, we forget to discuss the main agenda.
Recently, our newly elected OPC asked, what is CSH?
Wow. Some of our old-time aiders would turn in their graves listening to that.
Yeah, but we do have too many acronyms in aid, dude. CSH, CRF, OFI, REI, REI, RFI, CVC, BOD, OPC. Why blame new volunteers? We should blame Dwiji, Kiran, Nigamant for inventing these.
But it's no fun in CSH these days, dude. Remember the old times? we would get up on a Sunday morning and just rush to the CSH, no breakfast and all, eager with anticipation.
But I thought the no breakfast part was to allow for you to feast on the lunch buffet after CSH.
Arre nahi yaar, I remember the interactions we used to have with Swati, Michael, Anand, Dr. Devi or Yogesh Jain. And if it was not that, we would be discussing the next activist or speaker.
Yeah, I know. The good old days.
Well, and I remember how energizing it was to discuss projects in a dynamic where new people joined, older ones got them situated in aid, and gave them a canvas to make their own impression in aid.
What about now?
Now everybody in our chapter has their canvas shoes on and are running marathons away from me while I find myself to be the only one talking.
What's new there, dude?
No, but it gets tiring listening to your own voice after a while. It is kind of like being the only person liking your own Facebook post.
Haha, there's nothing wrong with that, man. Boston's chapter Arvind Prasad is famous for doing that. Also, this is what happens if you only post about aid stuff and your boring Saturday morning runs. People ignore you on Facebook.
Moving on. We haven't been able to get a dynamic of new volunteers, in-depth project reviews and follow-up with partners, camaraderie across chapters, and a deeper connection with the cause going.
Wow. Looks like you've been really thinking about the issues within aid.
You know, newsletters got done in time and publications was a buzzing place.
What about now?
The only buzzing you can hear right now in publications is from all the flies there. And Disha is no longer a newsletter, but more of a direction you want to go in.
And what about campaigns?
It's been so long since we ran a campaign that we'll need to start an aid campaign to get aid campaigns going.
Wait a minute, I have an idea for reviving aid campaigns. Let's get Dr. Bhagat to start his mails with Kranti instead of Shanti.
Well, some days if we took his Shanti literally and lowered our own voices and listened more, we would be better off. We are struggling, and I feel aid-wise on several metrics, we are underperforming.
I knew it. Just like Naga, you are also talking the MBA goobly-goo.
Yeah, whatever you say, like aid-wide teams, several aid chapters are also not anywhere near ideal strength.
Example?
There's so many, man. Bay Area, for example, should be named Bejan Area. Given how they struggle to even find quorum in their CSHs.
But I hear Boston is continuing to thrive and flourish. In fact, I hear the problem is they cannot find a room big enough to fit everybody. So they started a new program where volunteers are only allowed to attend one CSH a month.
Dude, I'm talking about regular chapters.
Your point is definitely taken about there being many things in the past that we are unable to emulate. But you also might be overly romanticizing the past.
Maybe so. But there is nothing more deflating than seeing things we did really well not getting done.
Never. You shouldn't lose heart, Ra. I've often seen this is precisely during these downturns that our efforts matter the most.
Oh no. Just when I was going to say I've had enough and I'm thinking of taking a long sabbatical, trust my luck to run into Buddha himself. Or is it Baba Ramdev?
Main Baba hoon ya Buddha? You will definitely benefit from continuing to do the pranayama and staying calm. But seriously, man, you need to stick around to see us through this rough patch. Greener shoots are just around the corner.
Appa, can you stop with these mixed metaphors? What do you mean greener shoots are around the corner? What is this? Another organic farm from your dreams or what? Dude, seriously, I need a break.
Yes, you do. But not a break from aid.
Yeah, maybe I just need a break from you.
Let's not get carried away. What you need is a break from aid
chapter and 8 white chores. And you need a trip to rural India to visit your favorite grassroots group. Say Mozda or JSS or Narmada Valley. While it is true that we need to introspect and relearn and adapt some of the things we are no longer able to do, we should also think about how today's aid can be most effective in today's India.
Right, right. I hear you're collaborating with Amir Khan to make PPK.
And two chapters are haggling over rights for this new venture, by the way.
Yeah. And there is a process underway to determine a process by which we come up with a committee which can put in place the process to resolve this issue.
Yeah, isn't it funny that with so many new tools available, aiders in different chapters are struggling to find a way to talk to each other?
Yes, I heard that Aid Ghar has been renamed Aid BB.
Aid BB? Aid Bulletin Board?
No man, Aid Bhoot Bangla.
Speaking of Bangla people, do you know that Nirvik almost missed the conference this year?
Yeah man. He left us all in suspense till the very end. Rumor has it that he just got back after a 2-month sabbatical.
Really? From where?
At an unspecified foreign destination. And he was attending Vipassana meditation courses to figure out a blueprint for Aid for the next 24 years.
I heard Aid Seattle and BOD folks got tired of answering what his date of return was. Apparently, he postponed it a few times.
I do wish sometimes that Naga and Nirvik thought more about the next 24 hours in AIDS. All the issues we seem to be having.
But seriously though, I actually think things like agris, issues like anti-GM, working with transgender and Dalit groups, or urban displacement and greater awareness about women's issues are much more mainstream in AIDS today.
Maybe so.
And speaking of newer initiatives, here is Newer. Hello Newer. Are you also here for the post-CSH Pongal and Dahi Vada?
Hello man. Eva, how nice to see you too. Just like how my brother shows up at the temple right in time for Prasad, you also show up for CSH just when there is free food.
As I was saying, we seem to be bogged down by the trivia. And like Ravi once said, the volume of our own voices seem to be drowning out the already faint voices of the people on the ground.
Oh, come on, man. It's not all that doom and gloom. Is it, Newer?
You two relics discussing the Stone Age again?
Something like that. You know, the Stone Age was much more fun, vibrant and fulfilling.
I keep hearing from you senior citizens about how good the good old days were and so on. In fact, that is all you seem to do. Talk about the old days, but don't do much for our present. But guess what? There are cool things going on right now too.
Like what?
Like, did you know that Renu actually did her PhD on AIDS?
I knew we had problems. I knew we had problems, but not enough for somebody to actually write a thesis on it.
Wait a minute. Is that why she talked to me? Wanted to know when I joined AID, the significance behind the colors of my kurta colors and all. It all makes sense now. So did my kurta color feature in her thesis?
Yeah, I don't think so. Once she picked her topic as AID, she quickly realized that the only constant in AID is Naga. So she just wrote about him.
Yeah. Constant and persistent, he sure is. In 2007, at the Tempe conference, there was a prowler on the loose. And last night at the Austin conference, there was a tornado lockdown. Through both of these, Naga was pitching fundraising initiatives to his captive audience.
Yeah, I admit I don't know what all Naga does. Perhaps this means we need to read her thesis ourselves. I wonder if it's being sold on Amazon.
Sold on Amazon? Newer, it's an academic thesis. These things are not sold, okay? Especially on Amazon.
Yes, there is absolutely no market for them. Venu will gladly give it to you for free. And probably give you $5 for reading it also.
Just like Pawan will give you $5 if somebody actually contributes an article for their conference. And by the way, he's still trying to get the Charlotte newsletter out.
Did you know that grant writing is a new initiative in A that has picked up steam?
About time. This is one thing we have talked about for years. Finally, it is happening.
You know what else is cool? A New York State chapter recently joined a march on climate change.
Did they do the march in April? Get it? Indian Standard Time? No? Okay, never mind.
At least the quality of jokes used to be better in this stone age.
What do you mean? They were finally able to get out of the house after the long winter. So they just kept on marching, celebrating the weather.
I'm going to ignore both of you and focus on all the awesome things going on in A. Like our collaboration with ThoughtWorks that has been very successful, where we helped fix the EMR problem for JSS.
There she goes again with another acronym. One thing we don't need to worry about is if acronyms have a future in aid or not.
Okay, I suppose those were the round the corner green shoots my friend was alluding to.
Hey, speaking of new things, what's happening with our Jeevan Sathis?
What about them?
Kiran Rachna and Jairam took a break from aid to pursue other endeavors. Rachna has since returned, not sure if Kiran is thinking about coming back to aid.
Kiran, Rachna are coming back? Did the EBBOD start a Ghar Vapsi program for the JSS?
Is Ghar Vapsi like a Ghar version 2.0?
No, like Balaji Sampath.
Eureka.
Yes, Eureka. Kamayani is hard at work in Bihar. I picked up Rash at the airport yesterday.
Oh, the good Rash that we all want to have. I heard he's the most sustainable JS. Does not even need a mic to speak.
By the way, did you know that Rash was an Aid Austin volunteer many years back? In fact, one of his signature initiatives was to start a mentoring program for new volunteers.
Yes, and the story goes that Vanilla was his assignment.
Exactly. When Aid Austin approved his Jeevan Sathiship, they meant it literally.
Dude, I saw Ravi's Facebook post the other day on kleptomaniac insanity and absence of left and right symmetry. I was so confused.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Ravi was writing about Arctic polarity, something to do with Shell's oil rigs in Arctic Sea. That's why there was a photo of two people in the boat paddling in the water.
Okay, and here I was thinking that Ravi was actually good at simplifying complex things for us as aiders, not confusing us more. Anyway, sounds like you folks are a bit behind on the activities of our Jeevan Sathis. Have you read their last reports and plans yet?
What reports?
See, looks like our JS liaisoning has become more of lying down and snoring.
By the way, I heard there will be two DCs. What will they call themselves? DC1, DC2? DC?
Hey, but I think that's a great direction, Newer. We need DCs to get work done in aid.
Never. I know what you're thinking. This doesn't mean you can relax in your comfy couch and catch up on Sunday Mahabharat and Game of Thrones episode on TV.
The thought never crossed my mind. Besides, there's enough Mahabharat and Game of Thrones happening in aid.
DCs are going to need volunteer support.
Then why do we have them?
No. The idea is that they will provide leadership to initiatives, help push important tasks to completion, and make us more efficient overall.
They sound like two politer versions of Naga.
I think that was part of the eligibility criteria.
All this is great, but what about all the things we aren't able to do anymore?
You know, never. You need to learn to let some things go. Things we might have done well in the past but cannot anymore.
Goodness, she makes me feel like I'm on my deathbed.
But instead of getting hung up about how we don't meet every weekend in person, you need to learn to see the benefits of Google Hangout CSHS.
Like?
like less driving, allowing for volunteering participation in your pajamas?
I guess. By the way, Nishikant is a proponent of Google Hangout too. Except he wants us to hang out with Aamir Khan. And he gave us a choice of 3 a.m. or 3:30 a.m.
Oh yeah, Nishikant is also checking if Aamir Khan can come to his graduation. And I heard JHU is fully cooperating as they will get a large crowd for commencement and also Nishikant will finally graduate.
Okay. Another item that keeps de-energizing us. Instead of feeling depressed about not doing a disha, how about we get behind something we can do about getting our word out?
She means once we figure out what the alternative is.
Exactly. I mean, I see Newar's logic, but we shouldn't give up on things we could get back to doing again.
Nobody's saying that, Nevarbhai. I've also heard this argument made many times about us focusing better instead of running after too many things. There's this new volunteer.
And who might you be?
You don't know me. I've been more regular at CSHs and conferences than even Never Uncle.
No, my dear. I know who you are. Who is this uncle with you?
Hello. You have more salt in your hair than pepper. It's not good for your heart, man. Not good.
Okay. Folks, meet Fewer, a new volunteer.
New volunteer? Has he or has he not attended 3 CSHs?
Dude, you are incorrigible. Just because you are one vote short of getting your favorite project approved.
What to do, man, Never? You don't attend 3 CSHs in a row in such a long time. I'm kind of getting desperate. Although in Austin, running a marathon qualifies you to vote in CSH.
Wait, but Pure is a cool guy. He's sensitive to social issues, talks about not drinking bottled water and all. There is potential, I think.
Potential for what? EV nomination? Nowadays, as soon as somebody attends 3 CSHs in a row, we think of them as leadership material.
Hey, Fewer. It's been nice knowing you.
What?
I mean, it was nice to meet you. So, how do you find aid?
Interesting.
Oh, no.
No. I mean, there is much that I like about aid. And I also see several things that we could do more efficiently.
And younger, what do you like about aid?
Well, I like aid conferences because I get to meet my friends Adrita, Anika, Sahit, Reva, and all. I love the kids' conference and all the cool things we made and the songs we sang. I love being allowed to stay up late at night during aid gatherings.
And what do you not like?
You know, I don't like hearing the same questions repeated at every CSH. Is this project sustainable? And you all keep saying things like zero waste, starting CSH on time, reaching out to people from diverse backgrounds, etc. But you keep going to the same desi buffet place after every CSH that begins late, and you look the other way when the restaurant uses styrofoam.
Younger, thank you. Looks like I'm not the only one who sees these dichotomies.
Oh, please never. Younger shows up at every CSH, conference or campaign event, and then brings up her issues. You, on the other hand, disappear when you have a dilemma in aid.
Okay, auntie and uncles, I need to go join my friends now. Bye for now.
Good. I was just telling them about the new initiatives you were talking about over dinner the other day. You want to elaborate?
Yeah, so basically, Fewer...
It's Never.
Oh, sorry, Never. I was advocating that aid should reduce the scope of its activities. Instead of trying to be Jack
and Jill
and of all trades, it would be better to focus on a smaller set of activities as well, you know, and do them really well. Just like Aamir Khan.
Why is everyone talking about Aamir Khan all of a sudden?
Because Shah Rukh Khan is not doing a Swadesh Part 2 anytime soon. And besides, it's better to be talking about Aamir than Salman nowadays.
And you know, what about having a unified website? I heard this has been discussed a lot, but there's not been much progress.
Yes, we are waiting until we all unify behind the idea. Then we'll work on the unified website.
Also, we seem to want to do too many things and inevitably we fall short and are not able to do justice to all of them. So how about having really crisp, focused 5-year plans?
Yes, as long as volunteers focus and read and provide feedback on these plans, preferably in less than 5 years.
And we talked about concerts and how they are too much effort for too little gain. They have just not been very effective in raising funds, have they?
Dude, if you make statements like these, we run the risk of triggering Jandy and Nishikant simultaneously. And we will not know what hit us.
Yeah, speaking of our awesome fundraising coordinator friend Jandy, from his emails, I cannot figure out if he's being nice, he's unhappy, or if he's cracking a joke.
Yeah. Having a conversation with Jandy is like trying to drink water from a riot police water cannon. Using a straw. You can be all elegant and try to sip slowly without slurping. But the torrent of water is going to crush your straw, wash over your face, and leave you gasping for air.
We think donor dinners are more effective than concerts anyway. We need a better way to communicate with our volunteers. We need to set realistic goals and get behind them and achieve small victories. And there's
whoa,
this
whoa,
like...
whoa, whoa. Hang on, guys. You discussed all of this over one dinner? What the heck were you eating? Or drinking at this meal?
That's what good wine does to you. Speaking of wine or the lack thereof, ever since we back.
You know, never. You and I are the only ones who attended the last conference in Austin way back in 2004, and then again this year.
Yeah, some things in it are still good.
Finally.
Yeah, like this Austin chapter. They energize me when I look at them. And you know, Ajay Kumar, Bharat Patel, Srinivasan, just like Rajendra Singh and Chennaiah, brought us back to our feet in 2004.
Maybe there is hope after all. Green shoot?
Stop!
You know, if only we found a way to take the best of the past and blend them with the realities of today, let the innovation and energy thrive again in aid and focus on what we do well, the aid that Younger and her friends are growing up with is still a great place and our best is still ahead of us.
Our best is still ahead of us as we approach our silver jubilee year. Sounds like a plan to me. Mm-hmm.
Indeed, like somebody said, if you want to run fast, run alone. If you want to go far, then run together.
Okay, Baba
Ramdev.
Come, let's go eat at the buffet that Younger was talking about.